Students, so now I will explain the human embryonic development. Human embryo development. So in the previous class, we start the human embryo development, but it stopped the blastocyst stage. The human embryo started with the first stage is cleavage, and the second one is marula. And third one is blastocyst. So where in previous class we stopped at the blastocyst. So next embryonic development stage is implantation. Implantation. So now the embryo is reached the uterus for further development. So the embryo is externally covered by zona pellucida membrane. So still the zona pellucida is externally covered embryo. So gradually this is disappear. So now the trophoblast is stick to the endometrium of uterus. The trophoblastic villus, which is invades into thickness of the endometrium of uterus, this is called as interstitial implantation. When the zona pellucida is disappear, the trophoblast is invades to endometrium of uterus. This is called as implantation. The implantation is begins the end of the sixth day of fertilization. So this after implantation, the endometrium, so in this process, implantation process, some proteolytic enzymes are involved. Proteolytic enzymes. So these proteolytic enzymes, which is involves the stick and invades the endometrium of uterus. These proteolytic enzymes are arise from the trophoblast, which is produced from trophoblast, and also produced from lumen of the uterus, which is involving the implantation. So next, after implantation, this is the endometrium of uterus. This is differentiated. So it will be differentiated into the decidua. Decidua. So after implantation, the endometrium of uterus differentiated into the decidua. Decidua means that is the shed off layer. Shed off layer during the delivery. So this is about the decidua. So the decidua is divides into, so differentiated into three parts. Decidua differentiated into three types. Now the portion of endometrium or decidua where placenta are formed, that is called is decidua. Decidua parietalis. Decidua differentiated into three types. So here decidua parietalis. Decidua parietalis means the decidua where placenta. So the placenta is the structurally functionally present between the embryo and the mother. So this placenta where formed, that part of decidua are called is decidua parietalis. Next, decidua capsularis. So decidua capsularis means the decidua separated from the embryo to the uterus, lumen of the uterus. So here embryo, that is separated to the lumen. So here not a association. So this part of decidua are called is decidua capsularis. Decidua capsularis means the portion of decidua that is separated to lumen of mother uterus, that part is called is decidua capsularis. Next one, decidua, sorry, this is the basalis and this is the parietalis. Decidua parietalis. So the decidua parietalis means, so the portion of the decidua that is lining rest on the, so inner lining of the uterus, so that is called is decidua parietal. Decidua basalis, decidua capsularis, decidua parietalis. This is the three portion of the decidua. So this is the shed of layer during the delivery or parturition. So the decidua also shed up. This is most outside with the along with the placenta and placental membranes. This is about the implantation. So next, so implantation completed at the end of the second week. End of second week, implantation is completed. This is the, about the embryo. So now this is the blastocyst embryo after implantation. The embryo look like a disc-like structure. Look like a disc-like structure. So the rubber cells are gradually disappear. So now the embryo exposing clearly rubber cell. So the rubber cell are gradually disappear. The embryonic disc is looks clearly. After, so some cells of inner cells of inner cell mass, some cells of inside of the internal side of inner cell mass, which is devoids delamination process, which is moves towards posterior side and form a layer. This is called as hypoblast. Hypoblast. So this is the inner cell mass. Some cells inside of the inner cell mass divides by the delamination process. Delamination means forcibly dividing. Delamination process, the cells moves towards posterior side. Here form a layer that is called as hypoblast. Next, the remaining cells of inner cell mass, remaining here inner cell mass, which is form another layer, this is called as epiblast. This is called as epiblast. So now embryonic cell, embryonic disc, so convert into bilaminar membrane. So the hence it is form a fifth stage is bilaminar, formation of bilaminar embryonic disc. Embryonic disc. So fifth stage is formation of embryonic disc. Now, so this is two layers are formed. One is epiblast and another one is hypoblast. So the epiblast cells, the hypoblast cells are, which is future extra embryonic ectoderm, future extra embryonic endoderm. So this is the hypoblast. Next, epiblast. So these hypoblast cells, which is spread extending along the trophoblast, finally enclose the yolk sac. Finally enclose the yolk sac. So this is about the formation of bilaminar embryonic disc. Next, sixth stage is gastrulation. Gastrulation. So this is the important stage, gastrulation. So the gastrulation involves the differentiation and proliferation and the rapid movements of cells within the happen within the embryonic disc. So this is about the gastrulation. So during the gastrulation process, so this is the embryonic disc, this is the trophoblast, this is the embryonic disc. When rubber cells are disappeared, so it is look clearly. So along the longitudinal axis of embryonic disc, a streak is appear. Streak means a line. A line is appear. This streak is called as primitive streak. Primitive streak. And along the midline of a primitive streak, a furrow is formed. Furrow. So this furrow is called as primitive groove. Primitive groove. Next, along the either sides of primitive groove, two folds are formed. Two folds. So these folds are called as primitive fold. Primitive fold. Primitive fold. So next, the anterior part of primitive streak, a shallow part is formed. This is called as primitive pitch. Primitive pitch. And above the primitive pitch, a thickness part is formed. This is called primitive note. Primitive node and also called Kensen's node. So this is about the gastrulation. During the gastrulation, the bilaminar membrane converted into the trilaminar membrane. So this is about the gastrulation. First, a streak is appear. This is called as primitive streak. And along the mid the part of primitive streak, primitive groove is formed. Either side, two folds are present. This is called as primitive fold. And other one is primitive pitch. This is shallow part. Above the shallow part, primitive node is formed. This is about the gastrulation.
Next to diagram, another thing.